Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to reconcile business credit card accounts in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Similar to your personal credit card accounts, it is important that you reconcile your business credit card accounts on a monthly basis. Reconciling is the process of matching the transactions on your credit card statement to what you have recorded in QuickBooks. Reconciling your credit card accounts regularly will help to ensure any discrepancies between your records and the credit card companies are resolved in a timely manner. For example, a credit card charge that comes through for a different amount from what you authorized. It will also ensure timely notification of any fraudulent transactions. For example, if you notice transactions listed on your credit card statement that you did not authorize, you can notify the bank as soon as possible so that they can investigate. Some of the benefits of reconciling your business credit cards in QuickBooks Online are: all transactions on the credit card statement get recorded in QuickBooks. All of the reconciled transactions are marked in QuickBooks as cleared. This means your transactions are matched up with what's on your credit card statement. Your financial statements, such as your profit and loss statement and balance sheet, are up to date. You are able to run credit card reconciliation reports that will provide both a summary and detail of all credit card charges and credits. Before you follow the steps to reconcile, be sure that you have your credit card statement handy for the credit card that you want to reconcile. We will refer to the credit card statement often during this process. From the home page, go ahead and click on the gear icon and go down to Reconcile below the Tools column. We will complete these fields using the credit card statement for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. From this screen, you want to click the drop down and select the credit card account that you want to reconcile. And then you can go ahead and click the Reconcile Now button once you've done that. All right, here's where our credit card statement comes in handy. So the first field that we need to complete is the statement ending date. Your credit card statement will have a beginning date and an ending date, so you want to enter the ending date in this field here. The beginning balance. Your credit card statement will have a beginning balance, and you want to enter that balance in this field. If the credit card was previously reconciled, as in this case, then this field will display the ending balance of last month, which is the beginning balance of the current month, and should match up the beginning balance that's on your current credit card statement. Ending balance. Enter the ending balance that appears on your credit card statement. This is the amount that you want to reconcile to, meaning that you'll need to get to this balance at the end after all transactions have been matched. Finance charges. If your credit card company charges you finance charges, you want to go ahead and enter that information in the finance charge field here. And then the date of the finance charges should be the same date as your statement ending date. You also want to categorize these charges into an account on your chart of accounts. If you have not set up an account to categorize your finance charges, be sure to watch our video tutorial on how to set up the chart of accounts. Click here to watch that video. Once you've completed all of the fields on this screen, you want to go ahead and click OK. On the next screen, we've got charges and cash advances listed on the left here. And then on the right side, we've got payments and credits listed. Before we begin to match up transactions, double check that the information we entered from the credit card statement is correct. This information appears at the very bottom of the screen. If you need to edit any of this information, you simply want to just click on the Edit Information from Statement link. The other thing you want to make sure that you do is we want to go ahead and make sure the check mark next to hide transactions after the statement's end date box is checked. Hiding these transactions means that you won't see transactions that took place after the statement ending date that you are reconciling. So for example, our statement ending date is October 31st, 2016. So by checking this box, we will not see any transactions dated November 1st or after. This makes reconciling much simpler. Let's go ahead and start with the charges and cash advances section. Refer to your credit card statement, and for each charge or cash advance that appears on your credit card statement, you want to go ahead and put a check mark next to it in QuickBooks here. QuickBooks will put a check mark next to that item. You also want to make sure that you mark off each item on your statement with a check mark as you mark it in QuickBooks. Once every item on your credit card statement has been marked off, check to see if the charges and cash advances total in QuickBooks matches the total charge and cash advance on your credit card statement here. So notice our total for this is $424. This should match up with your credit card statement for charges and cash advances. Your credit card statement may separate the credit card charges from cash advances. If it does, in order for you to match up with the QuickBooks total, you will have to add these two items up to get one total amount. Similar to what we just did for charges and cash advances, we want to go ahead and do the same thing for each payment and credit that appears on your credit card statement. Check it off in the Reconcile screen by clicking on it as we've done here, and then you want to go ahead and check it off on your paper statement as well. Once every item on your credit card statement has been marked off, check to see if the payments and credits total in QuickBooks matches the total on your credit card statement. So we want to make sure for our statement that we've got $105 for payments and credits on our credit card statement. Our ultimate goal is to have a difference of zero. If your difference is not zero, then you want to try some of the troubleshooting steps. Let's go ahead and talk about 8 troubleshooting tips for reconciling credit card accounts in QuickBooks Online. Tip number 1, if possible, narrow the search down to the transaction type. Figure out if you are out of balance with the charges and cash advances or payments and credits. So just as we talked about a few minutes ago, you want to make sure that you're matching up the total that's in QuickBooks matches with your credit card statement. And you want to determine if the out of balance is with charges and cash advances or with payments and credits. Now, if you happen to be out of balance for both charges, cash advances, and payments and credits, then tackle them separately. So in other words, balance your charges and cash advances first and then move on to the payments and credits or vice versa. Tip number 3, look for the exact dollar amount that you are off by. So for example, if your difference here is $50, then look for a transaction for this amount on your credit card statement. And then also look on both the checks and payments section and the payments and credits side of the reconcile window. Tip number 4, triple check the information that you entered from the credit card statement. I cannot stress this enough. At making sure that this information has been entered correctly is key. If you transpose the number when you entered it, that's going to cause your out of balance as well. So you want to go ahead and click that link and verify that this information is correct. Once you have done that, go ahead and close out. Tip number 5, check to see if there are any transactions in the reconcile window that you did not put a check mark next to. If the transaction is on your credit card statement, then it should have a check mark next to it in the QuickBooks Reconcile window here. Tip number 6, if you do have a transaction on the credit card statement that is not in QuickBooks, then you will need to add it to QuickBooks. To do so, you want to go ahead and click the Finish Later button here. By clicking the Finish Later button, QuickBooks will save the work that you have done so far, and you will easily be able to come back and pick up where you left off. If the missing transaction is in the charges or cash advances, then go ahead and enter it as you normally would. In our How to Manually Enter Business Credit Card Transactions lesson, we walk you through step by step on how to enter credit card transactions in QuickBooks. If the missing transaction is in the payments or credit section, then enter it as you normally would. In our How to Enter Credit Card Returns lesson, we walk you through step by step how to enter credits in QuickBooks. Click here now to watch that video. Tip number 7, take a break. If you've been at it for a while and you need a break, clicking the Finish Later button, as we talked about a second ago, will save the work that you have done and you can easily pick up where you left off when you're ready. Sometimes taking a breather and coming back can help you spot what's causing the difference. Tip number 8, and it's a key one. While it might be tempting, I recommend that you don't click that reconcile button until you have a difference of 0. I promise you that the problem will not go away. The difference will just carry over to the next month until you figure it out. If you do hit the finish now button and you have a difference, QuickBooks will record the out of balance amount in a miscellaneous expense account called unreconciled discrepancies. Of course, if we're talking a small amount, $5 or less, for example, then it might be worth your while to move on. At the end of the day, you get to determine what amount you are comfortable with. Since we do have a difference of 0, we can go ahead and click our Finish Now button. And behind the scenes, QuickBooks will mark all of these items as cleared. QuickBooks will also generate our bank reconciliation reports. From this screen, we've got a few options. We could write a check for our credit card amount, we could enter a bill, or we could leave the balance in the reconciled account. So we'll choose to leave the balance in the reconciled account as we'll pay our credit card later. That brings us to this screen here. And so from this screen, we can go ahead and click on our reconciliation report that was generated. Similar to what we discussed in how to reconcile your bank accounts lesson, you should create a folder to keep all credit card reconciliation reports in. I recommend one folder per credit card. So let's take a look at our reconciliation report. We've got a summary section and a detailed section. And then most important, we've got the statement ending balance, that's our credit card balance, and we've got the register balance. Notice that they are in agreement, they match up. So that was really the whole goal of reconciling this, is to make sure that our QuickBooks matches our credit card statement. So we have achieved that goal. Credit card reconciliation reports are one of the top 5 reports that auditors will request. In my experience as an auditor, if you are unable to produce these reports, the audit will not go well for you. Another thing that QuickBooks does behind the scenes when you reconcile transactions is it also marks these transactions in the register as reconciled. So we'll go ahead and navigate back to the credit card register and take a look at that now. To navigate back to the register, you want to click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name. And then we'll go ahead and select chart of accounts. And then we'll go ahead and scroll down to our credit card. And to view the register, just click on the view register link to the far right. Notice that the transactions that we have reconciled have the letter R in this column. So this means that they have cleared the bank and they match our credit card statement. Typically, once a credit card transaction is reconciled, you do not want to make any changes to it. This is primarily due to the fact that you have balanced it with your credit card statement. You can edit the account if you need to. So for example, if you categorize something as meals and entertainment and it should have been office supplies, definitely go ahead and make that change. But you do not want to make any changes to the date or the amount. If you do, it can cause your financial statements to be inaccurate and you will no longer be in balance with your credit card company. That wraps up the lesson on how to reconcile business credit card accounts in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.